Okay, doing something wrong the right way. What does that mean? When you work on electricity, you're not supposed to work on it live. You can, sometimes if you have to, but try to avoid it as much as possible. This is just a simple illustration. I'm not pulling any load at all here. So you won't even see a spark from the hot side. You'll see me test the voltage when I start out, when I finish. I didn't even have to reset a breaker or nothing like that. Can come in handy knowing this stuff. You also see me use gloves and have a special leader nose, which is very high rated for working electrical stuff. Some of my tools are that way. My lineman pliers, pair of strippers, other stuff. Can you put that right there? Thank you. That's my wife. She's bringing me dinner. So you see some of my tools, and you can actually see the video was prior to this one. Maybe two videos before this will be about that needle nose. Very cool stuff. Knipex, okay? I used to say Knipex all the time, and I'm thinking I'm wrong. So hopefully somebody corrects me. Lets me know if I'm right or I'm wrong or what. I would appreciate it. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Okay, this might be an interesting video to some. How to do the wrong thing the right way. Basically, you're supposed to shut off the power when you work on an outlet or something. You might be on a farm somewhere where the service goes to the road and you have to run the line to your unit, your location. So that could be a thing. This looks like a metal box here, and it is taped around the side, so that is good. That's how we do it up north. We put tape around it and we use metal boxes, and the boxes are usually grounded with some kind of armored cable. So you don't always have to run a ground wire. So that could be a useful thing. Now the small side should be the hot, neutral should be here, and the ground the, I guess, half moon kinda. Okay. This might have been something I did. Okay, we got one hot, so we know which is hot already. One ground and one neutral. This one shouldn't be that hard. Sometimes you have four wires. And I'm not pulling any load, as you guys can see. So once we take the hot off, we should be fine with no power going to the device. In this case, it's the outlet over here. And that one's giving me a little bit of trouble. Since I'm not pulling any current, I shouldn't really see any sparks. If you're pulling current, you can see a spark. And that could be kind of tricky. Okay, I think I got it, mostly. Yep, okay. She's pretty thick, the wiring. I'm going to say she's for a 20 amp, 12 gauge. 14 gauge would be for a 15 amp circuit. Okay. Somebody ran this. They did pretty good, whoever ran this. The only reason I say I might have been the one to do this because I don't see people down here use electrical tape on outlets like we do up north. I might have been the one that did that. Apologize about the AC noise. Now we're going to test with our meter, see if it's still alive. See what kind of current we might have. I'm testing it to the ground. 122.3.4. Hopefully that shows up in the image. Okay? So that's still live. Once I know this is live, these two are dead right now. There's no neutral power going back to the source, and the ground is just grounded out. What I understand, somebody corrected me years ago He said that they're connected together, they're not going to the plumbing all the time. And when I spoke to the guy, I wrote to him a year later, said he was correct. He said that I was also correct because they do come different ways in different places. So that kind of surprised me. But at least I manned up and said he was correct, you know. Now you notice I'll take the neutral off. I took the hot off first. And then I'll take the ground off last and I'll go in reverse. When I put whatever back in here, I will actually just take off. Okay. Now we'll get a new outlet to put in there. Now this is copper wiring. I can use a regular outlet here and I have cola. So I'm going to go for a regular outlet. This is a good one because it has those things in the back where you can shove your wires in. You don't have to necessarily use the screws. And silver would be for the neutral, would be on the large side. Colored side would be for the hot on the small side. Okay, so we're gonna put these all back together. And we're gonna go in reverse now. Ground first, neutral second, hot last. Okay. I got a really cool tool to show you guys here. There it is, my Nipex, one of my previous videos. And it works better than my Klein 20-year-old wire strippers because it has that tapered needle nose. So I really like that a lot. Okay. Now the only time we're gonna come in danger here is when you're playing with the hot side. We don't wanna play with it too much. So. Okay, that should be okay. I shouldn't have any problems with that. Pretty tight. Last side is here, and I'm gonna put some tape on here. I'm not going to leave it like that. You see, I didn't get no real sparks here, which is nice because I don't necessarily want sparks. But again, I'm not pulling no current. There's nothing plugged into this device, this outlet. So that's one of the things you want to remember. You don't necessarily want to we'll test it again before we tape it up, put it back in, end the video and all that. Just to show you it's still live. There's my screwdriver on the floor. First was my meter. I also got a new meter coming, which I think most of you guys are going to be surprised when you see it. For the price I paid for it, it's really a bargain. So I can't wait to put that video up. Okay, get over there. That's the hot side. And we got 122.8. Hopefully you guys can read that. Okay? So it's still live. I can end the video here because I don't need you guys to see me tape it up, put it back in the box. It's elementary stuff. Okay, hope you guys enjoyed the video. Oh well. Putting it back in place, I had to push the wires in. And you can see I put yellow tape on there. I've been doing that for a while when I first came here, like almost 7 years ago. I would use colored tape so people know I was the one that was there. You see, electricians do that a lot. Push everything in place like that. So everything goes in nice smoothly. Okay. Okay, she's back in place. Solid. No issues. I didn't need no spacers, nothing like that, so everything's cool. All I gotta do is put a cover on there, and I'm done.